Class, in this tutorial, we want to look at how what different landscapes would look like on a topographic map. Essentially, a topographic map shows the shape of the land surface using contour lines. Those lines represent areas of equal elevation. What we've collected here are several pairs of well-known landmarks in Oregon with their corresponding topographic map. So you can see what the area looks like and also what the area would appear like on a contour map. This first image is, of course, Crater Lake, probably Oregon's best known natural feature. In the middle of Crater Lake, we have Wizard Island, a cinder cone with its associated lava flow. So this is what Wizard Island's topographic map looks like. The previous photo of Wizard Island was taken from the west looking towards the east. We see the nice circular contours that outline the cinder cone of Wizard Island. In the center, that cinder cone has a small crater depression. And depressions on topographic maps are illustrated with contour lines that have little tick marks pointing inward, indicating the down direction. You also remember from the photo that Wizard Island has a lava flow that projects to the west. That's the relatively flat area that we see here with more widely spaced contours. Remember, the space in between contours indicates the relative steepness of the slope. The cinder cone on Wizard Island is relatively steep, so we see a series of closely spaced contours. The lava flow is much flatter. Here, contour lines are more widely spaced, indicating a gentler slope. This photo shows Wallawa Lake, which is in northeast Oregon near the town of Joseph. Wallawa Lake was formed when an Ice Age glacier advanced out of the Wallawa Mountains into the larger Joseph Valley, forming a series of moraines that now dam Wallawa Lake. Notice in the photo that we have steep mountain slopes to the south. We have the broader, flatter Wallawa Valley here in the foreground. And then we have the moraines that encircle Wallawa Lake, which are relatively steep, but not as steep as the mountain slopes behind them. Think about what this area would look like on a topographic map. We're going to have very closely spaced contours in this area, indicating steep slopes. Widely spaced contours here, 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 indicating much flatter slopes. And the contours are going to form loops outlining the ridge or moraine that encircles Wallawa Lake. So this is Wallawa Lake's topographic map. In the previous photo, we were looking at Wallawa Lake from the north. The camera was pointed towards the south. We expected to see closely spaced contours representing the mountain slopes to the south of Wallawa Lake, and that's what we see. These contours are very, very closely spaced, indicating very steep slopes. At the far end of Wallawa Lake, we see this relatively flat area with widely spaced contours representing the deep valley through which the Ice Age glacier advanced. As that glacier advanced into the broader Wallawa Valley, again, more widely spaced contours than what we see in the mountains to the south, it deposited a series of moraines that now encircle Wallawa Lake. Notice how the contours are shaped something like this, outlining the ridge crests or moraine crests on either side of Wallawa Lake. This photo shows Kyger Gorge, which is on Steens Mountain in southeast Oregon. Kyger Gorge is another deep, glacially carved valley. It has the U shape that is characteristic of valleys that have been eroded by glaciers. Think about what the topographic map of this area would look like. our contours would be widely spaced on the valley bottom, but much more closely spaced on the valley sides, where the slope is much steeper. Along the ridges that border Khyber Gorge, the contours would be shaped something like this. These prominent notches in the wall, mountain wall to the east of Khyber Gorge, would show up as little gaps in the contours, indicating an area where the ridge had a lower elevation. This is the topographic map for Khyber Gorge. As we expected to see, we see contours that are U-shaped outlining the valley floor. Notice that the elevations increase as we move up the valley. Along the sides of Khyber Gorge, we find very closely spaced contours, indicating much steeper slopes than we have on the valley bottom. Then we also see gaps, if you will, in those contours along the ridge crest that indicate depressions where the valley walls are not as high. Around the rim of Khyber Gorge, up on the plateau of Steens Mountain, once again we enter an area with flatter ground and much more widely spaced contours. Notice also the steep headwall at the head of Khyber Gorge, again very closely spaced contours indicating very steep terrain. This photo shows Mount Jefferson, which is the second tallest peak in Oregon after Mount Hood. To the north of Mount Jefferson, we find this flat area called Jefferson Park, a subalpine meadow with a number of small lakes on the flat valley floor. Again, let's think about what the topographic map of this area would look like. The floor of Jefferson Park, widely spaced contours, gentle or flat ground. Mount Jefferson itself, very closely spaced contours, steeper slopes. Elevations increasing as we move up towards the peak of Mount Jefferson. This is the topographic map showing Jefferson Park and Mount Jefferson to the south. The photo on the previous slide was taken from this area, and the camera is viewing towards the south. Here's the flat area of Jefferson Park. It's open meadow. Notice how widely spaced the contours are in this area, indicating very gentle or flat ground. To the south of Jefferson Park, we find much more closely spaced contours, elevations increasing as we move in this direction towards the summit of Mount Jefferson.